Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be answering a Quora question, which is, can I edit my components in another file to use it later in my Sketchup? My Sketchup is running slow after importing components. The answer here, which was upvoted, says, no, you can't. But actually, the real answer is, yes, you can. Maybe it's not the best way to help with speed, but you can certainly edit components outside in another file and use them later in your SketchUp. And in this video, that's what I'm going to show you how to do. Okay, so I open up this SketchUp model, and I'm just gonna make a few different shapes so that I can sort of display this example. Okay, so we have four different shapes, and obviously the cube and the rectangular prism have a lot less faces than the donut or the cone here. So I'm just gonna show you how to swap them out, and then how you might use this in modeling. So if I right-click on this and go down to Save As, I'm just gonna make, components folder. That's kind of cool. And say that is cube, right click on this, save as, rectangular prism, right click, save as, donut, right click, save as, cone. There we go. So now what we can do is, if for whatever reason I wanted to change this donut to the rectangular prism, you just right click and go to reload. It'll ask you for the file. So I'm just gonna hit rectangular prism and it changes that to a rectangular prism. And same thing with this. I wanna change it to, let's say, the cube. So that's the answer to the question. Yes, you can do that. This may not be the most useful. What you may wanna do is something like making a placeholder. So maybe instead of the donut, because it has a lot of facets, maybe you essentially make a cube or a rectangular prism that is, I'm just gonna move this a teeny bit, essentially the same height. The same dimensions as the donut, and that way you can place it . I'm just going to show you something afterwards . So maybe you have a file that's kind of like this. Maybe you save this as donut placeholder. So I'm going to delete these other things. I'm going to delete our scale figure here. And I'm going to copy this, let's say 20 feet, and make 200 of these. Okay, so there's a whole bunch of them. What I'm going to do is delete this donut, and then I'm gonna go, this is how you would, I'm gonna purge unused. It's gonna get rid of anything that I'm not using. So that's done. Now what I'm gonna do is save as. So let's say, placeholder. Okay, so now I have these 200 things. I have a file called placeholder. And I'm gonna right click on this, hit reload, hit donut, and it's gonna change all of those out. And then I'm gonna right click, hit save as. I'm gonna say donut. These are two separate files. Now what I'm gonna do is open, so we can look at the file size, look at details, date modified. So you can see that the donut is more than 2 times bigger file size than the placeholder. And of course, this will speed up your computer. If there's less information for it to load, it'll be easier to model. So it may be worth considering using a placeholder instead of a more complex shape while you're modeling a whole bunch of stuff. But this shouldn't be your only solution for speeding up your model. If you're trying to speed up your model, you want to make sure that you're purging any unused components. You want to make sure that there are no hidden geometries that you're not going to need. If there's a bunch of those, you want to delete them. Make a copy and then delete everything in case you end up needing to find something. And that's it. If you thought that this video was helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.